I was admitted to St Vincent's Hospital in Melbourne for the replacement of my aorta valve.
I remember we went and saw her really quickly when she was still in ICU. You could see she wasn't herself.
A lot of sort of mumbo jumbo, you know, not a lot made sense.
I told them that a gorilla came up in the lift with me.
Audrey Curtis was a patient of ours at the hospital who happened to be involved with one of our research projects looking at delirium after cardiac surgery.
After visiting hours, I presume I'd been settled down into bed. Heavy metal music suddenly came on the television. I've got this band there, and it was like a 3D. It was like they came out of the television. I sort of had the feeling that I'd been kidnapped and that I had been wrapped in rope, tied to a post. I started to pull at what I thought was the ropes to get them off me. So I pulled everything, and it turned out to be the tubes that were still in my body. By the time I'd finished, I'd pulled every single tube out of my body. I thought, oh gosh, what have I done? So I rang the bell for a nurse to come, and I was feeling very guilty because of what I'd done. And anyway, she came and she said to me, look, don't worry about it. This is something that happens.
It was a really distressing event for her.
An agitated episode of delirium, which you remember, creates in a person a frightening experience and something akin to a post-traumatic stress disorder.
But the next vision was of this, like, it'd be like a hall, like a ward, but it was filled with beds, empty beds. I can definitely remember the vision of just this hallway with all these beds in.
What makes delirium challenging is that it's a disorder of thinking. It is unpredictable, but is more likely to occur in older patients having anaesthesia and surgery and the stress associated with that.
We know that there's a fourfold increase in mortality in patients who have an episode of delirium. Up to 50% of patients having cardiac surgery might have an episode of delirium. Hyperactive delirium, where patients are agitated like that, is quite different to hypoactive delirium, where patients are a little bit more stuporosed, they're very quiet, but in fact, if you ask them, they're very confused, they might be having hallucinations, and they tend not to talk about those things unless they're asked.
I suppose I've had a chance to come to terms with it, but the fact that it has still stayed there, even now, it's nearly 2 years, and that memory is still very, very vivid.
We still don't know exactly what is the cause of delirium in the brain. One of the most important things is to talk to patients before surgery who are at risk in particular and say, look, this might happen to you. If it does, don't feel afraid. We'll do our best to get you through it. It's really important that older patients have some form of cognitive screening prior to being admitted to hospital for surgery and anaesthesia, so that we're able to pick up people who are at risk. And we talk to their families and relatives, and we can use them as partners in trying to help prevent them from having these episodes, because one of the best things you can have is a familiar environment to prevent this occurring.
I think at this point in time, there isn't a consistent approach, but I think we're getting close to that.
So with the Patient Safety Movement Foundation, we're working with them at the moment to develop an APS, an actionable patient safety solution, based on post-operative delirium in the elderly patient. Over $150 billion is lost every year due to complications associated with delirium in hospital. We really do need to address this, and through APS, we will be able to, I think, get a broader reach for the prevention and management of delirium.
Audrey, she's really committed to trying to make sure this doesn't happen to other people.
Being involved has definitely given me some of my life back. Unless you experience anything like this yourself, you cannot really understand what the effect of that is on you, and it can affect not just you but everybody that's around you.